Hello students. So now today we'll do the revision of the chapter 4 lesson 4 operating system. So in this lesson operating system, so we have studied about this lesson 4 operating system. So as you know that operating system is the system software, and this system software acts as the interface between the computer software, that is application software, and the hardware. Whatever the application you are opening on the computer, so this operating system acts as an interface. Okay, so what you have studied, that operating system is a system software which acts as an interface between the software and the computer hardware. Okay, so operating systems controls and monitors the execution of programs, other programs and applications. So it performs the basic task. Basic task means recognizing the input from the keyboard, what input a user is giving from the keyboard. It sends the output to the monitor. It manages the files and directories on the storage devices, and it controls all the peripheral devices, means external devices which is attached to the computer, like the mouse, printer, scanner. So now, objectives of the operating system. So whatever the operating system is written, whatever system software is created, so behind that some objectives are kept in mind, that why we are going to write the operating system. So first objective is to manage the hardware and software. To manage the hardware means which is attached to the computer, and to manage all the software which is installed in the computer. Okay, second thing, to provide the interface for the users to communicate with the computer system. So some medium is needed by which the persons can communicate with the computer system, with the computer software and hardware. So to send messages to each application or interactive user about the status of the operation, that whether the file is opening or not, whether the file is existing or not, and any errors that may have occurred. So some message is required, so that without message how we communicate to other person. Fourth thing is that to be responsible for security and ensuring that unauthorized users do not access the system. Okay. So after that you can see some of the things. There is a components of the operating system. What are the components of the operating system? So that is the cell and kernel. Cell is the outer layer and the innermost layer over is called the kernel. Now cell handles the interaction with user. So first the users, whatever persons giving the commands, that is handled by the cell. See, or if your command is input output, your command is for the device services, your command is for networking, your command is for opening any application, your command is for opening any file. So this is first this command received by this cell. Now after cell, then the interaction with the hardware is done. So see, cell, an interface to the operating system is called a cell. So operating systems receives the commands through the cell. Okay. So this operating system receives the commands through the cell. It is the outermost layer of the operating system and manages the interaction between you and the operating system. This is the outermost layer, and with the help of this only we are able to communicate with the operating system. If the cell is not there, we cannot give the command to the OS, means operating system. Prompting you for the input, cell, it prompts you to give the input, means give the command. Whenever you open the docs, you find, you always see the cursor is blinking. That is prompting for the command. Interpreting that input for the operating system. So whatever the input you give, that cell interpret it, whether this command is for what? It is for application, it is for networking, it is for device, it is for files. Like this, it decides to whom this command is to be given. Handling the resulting output from the operating system. Now, after giving to the operating system, this output also handles. A cell provides a way for you to communicate with the operating system, either interactively means like giving input from the keyboard, or as a cell script. Shell script is a sequence of set of commands that are stored in a file, like switch on of the computer. Now you can see the kernel. So as you know, kernel is the core component of the operating system. So this kernel acts as the interface between the application and the data processing being performed at the hardware level. So when CPU when process this data, so with the CPU interaction is done with the kernel. So when an operating system is loaded into memory, the kernel loads first. So what loads? This kernel loads first and remains in memory. This kernel remains in the memory until the operating system is not shut down. So the role of the kernel is major in computer system. So the kernel provides and manages the computer resources. Kernel provides and manages all the computer resources and allow other programs to run and use these resources. So the kernel also sets up the memory address space for applications. So this kernel only assign the address space in the computer for the application which you want to open. Suppose the command is given to open the application, kernel will set the memory space in the computer, means in the RAM. Now loads the file with the application code in the memory and start the execution and set up the execution stack for programs. So here execution stacks means like you can see the stack of plates as you find in the wedding parties. So in the wedding parties you find what one over the other plates are there, so one can take the plates from the top only. So similarly here all the programs in here are loaded and stored in the form of the stack. First outer program means the program which is present on the top is taken from the stack and executed first. So the kernel is responsible for performing the following tasks. So what are the tasks which is done by the kernel? Input output management, memory management, which we have done what the input is given and output is also after processing it is delivered to the corresponding hardware, and memory management to all the application. It assigns the memory space in the computer and the RAM. Process management for application execution, how the processes will be managed, which process will be executed for what quantum of time. Device management means use of device drivers. System calls control, whenever any interrupt is generated, that is called the system calls, means some system calls generated by the keyboard and the mouse whenever you click on somewhere. So that is called the system call that is given to the processor immediately. That suppose if I click on here, that is the system call will be generated and this application will be closed immediately. So earlier all the basic system services like process and memory management, interrupt handling were packed into a single module in the kernel space, and this type of kernel was called the monolithic kernel. And the problem with this approach was that whole kernel had to be recompiled for even a small change. So if you want to make a small change, you have to recompile the whole program. So in modern day approach monolithic architecture, we have microkernel which contains different modules like different device management, file system module, protocol. Now if you want to do any changes, you have to do the changes, you have to compile only that file and the protocol file only, which can be dynamically loaded and unloaded. With this approach the kernel code size was reduced also, and while the stability increased. Okay, so this is all for today students, and you prepare for the your exam. So now the syllabus is completed, so every day during the computer class we will do the revisions. Okay, so this is all for today. Thank you for the attention.